Fuck it, let's talk about it. Hashtag I gets busy. Hashtag Frankie Diamonds TV. Hashtag fuck your hashtag. So, in case you've been under a rock, if you don't have Netflix, Oprah executive produced the movie When They See Us about the Central Park 5 story from 30 years ago. Now she's about to do an interview with the prosecutor, that evil bitch. I'm not even going to give her name out. And she's going to interview the victims, the five dudes, Corey Wise and all of them. Corey Wise, Kevin Richardson, Antron McCray, Raymond Jr., Yusef Salam. And I really wish they wouldn't do this interview. I'm going to review that movie. I thought the movie was great. Despite whatever. Now, this is Oprah coming off the hills of just producing that Michael Jackson doc, and she caught a lot of heat from that. But I thought it was a low blow. I mean, you wait till Michael Jackson's dead 10 years later to put out this tell-all documentary. I watched 40 minutes of that, and I couldn't get past it. It was just too much. And this is the same Oprah who is now trying to capitalize off the Stay Woke movement, and meaning where they take advantage of the socially black conscious and they try to take advantage of the non-socially black conscious who think they are. Because there's a lot of black people who think they're socially conscious that really aren't. They don't have a fucking idea. But they have basically used this as propaganda the last few years. You know, Childish Gambino's biggest hit was Stay Woke. You know, biggest hit, ironically, right? They commercialized the Stay Woke movement. And it's really about trying to get another Democrat in office, because we've got this whole bottom line. If we get Trump out, impeachment or by vote, everything would be great for black people again. But in reality, it was never great for us. In the last 50 years since we've been programmed to vote Democrat, when has it ever been great? It wasn't great when Kennedy was in office for us because we had Jim Crow. It wasn't great when Clinton was in office because we had the three strikes and the mass incarceration and all the scandals they had going on. It wasn't great when Obama was in office, to be honest. Employment was high, this and that. You could try to blame it on Bushes and all the aftermath, but it wasn't good for us no matter who was in office. So white supremacy in the system is bigger than just politics. It's bigger than Nino Brown. It don't really matter who's in office, because a lot of times getting a Democrat is the easiest way to deceive black people. That's deception one-on-one. We get so comfortable when someone is Democrat because we've been programmed that blue is true and red means you're dead, whatever. We've been programmed to think that if we get a Democrat in office, that we'll be fine and everything will be all good and dandy, but that's not the case. That's why I don't vote Democrat or Republican. But, you know, this is what the whole propaganda of that movement is. And Oprah was somebody who was a TV anchor way back in the 80s, knew well about this story, Central Park 5. Surprised she took this long to do it, which is another thing. She's doing it now all of a sudden in the heat of this whole Stay Woke movement where everybody in the country's divided. Come on now. You know, was very closely acquainted with Donald Trump in the late 80s and on beyond, knowing what Trump was on. Trump took out an 85,000 ad in the New York Times or the New York Post, wanted the death penalty for these five teenagers. She knew it, and she was still jigabooed up with Donald Trump. You know, Oprah's full of shit. She's an opportunist. And anytime she got an opportunity to coon it up or to take advantage of black people's subconsciousness, she does it. You know, since when is all of a sudden she's conscious and she cares about the black community? I remember when she was on her show years ago and said that we need to stop using slavery as an excuse. Like, we're not 400 years behind. Like, we couldn't read a book for 400 years. I'm like, bitch, are you crazy? But, you know, a lot of black people give Oprah a pass because, you know, she's so successful and she gives out free cars and she's the first black billionaire female. And I'm like, yeah, I get all of that. But true colors is true colors. Oprah ain't never been for the black struggle. Oprah ain't never been about black power. Oprah don't give a fuck about me, you, or the woman next door. Oprah's blew up off America because she came out at the right time, right place, and she had that target white middle-aged female fan base. That was who was in the audience. You know, Oprah caters to who she like any businessman or woman. She caters to the people that support her. And her biggest supporters have always been middle-aged white women. Period. So I'm not surprised. I'm more disappointed that these guys don't see through her fakeness and are going to do an interview with her. Now, I get it. They're just capitalizing off the moment. They on red carpets. They kind of like revived again. They're like stars again, but in a positive way. last time they were mentioned in the news like this was when the actual trial and the case went down 30 years ago. So I kind of understand that, but you couldn't get me to sit down with somebody who was associated with Trump like Oprah. You know, and if Oprah had any ounce of dignity, I definitely couldn't be associated. I couldn't interview that white bitch, that evil devil bitch, that prosecutor. Oh, my God. That's the type of motherfucker you spit in their face. She don't deserve a cordial conversation. That bitch, I mean, I'm going to get to that when I review that film. But, yeah, Oprah is just using, once again, just using the cause for just to get over with black folks. This is like when years ago when she put out that movie The Butler and came up with this racial story. Oh, I was discriminated in a store. And she did this a week before the movie came out so she could get you to feel sympathy for her so you could support that bullshit movie with Forrest Whitaker shucking and shot jiving and shining shoes. I mean, come on now. When does it stop? You know, it's sick. It's sick. So we can fall asleep again. And you know, because impeaching Trump is not the bottom line. I get it. Anything but Trump. But I'm sorry. Joe Biden is not going to fix our problems. You know, Barry Sanders is not going to fix it. Not Barry Sanders. Bernie Sanders. Excuse me. I watch a lot of football. None of them are going to fix our problems, dog. It's just the facts. And I'm not saying don't vote. I'm not saying lose hope. I'm just being honest. You know, this shit is bigger than politics. It always has been. It always will. It's nothing but a face. The puppet, the face of the franchise. But, yeah, Oprah's going to do this interview and take advantage. Because that's what she does. She's an opportunist. She's going to take advantage of what she sees is hot right now. And like I say, she's going to interview both parties. And I think she already interviewed the girl who got raped also. So, yeah, man, let me know what y'all think. I'm out. Like, share, subscribe.